Greetings, this is LGR Plays, and this is Guns of Icarus Online. It is a game released and developed by Muse Games, put out back in October 2012, and I'm just now getting around to it because, well, interesting things are happening with it. They keep updating it and adding stuff to it, and there's actually this going on here, which is the Adventure Mode Kickstarter thing. So at the moment, they're trying to really expand the game, add stuff like towns and trade and factions and a whole like persistent world to have going on within this game, which I think is pretty awesome. And I was also interested in this because I had played Air Buccaneers before and heard that this was pretty friggin' similar, but maybe even better. And I kind of liked Air Buccaneers, but yeah, I don't know. This actually seems a little bit more intriguing to me, just from what I've played of it so far, which isn't a ton, but... yeah. So as you can see here, you have these airships that are very, actually freaking awesome looking. I think this sort of steampunk, diesel punk thing going on, supposedly. And yeah, I guess that's what you can call it. It's just really interesting designs. You have all these different ships, and you also have different roles that you can play within these games. And yes, it is online only, since hence the name called Online. So for $20 normally, or $33 for the collector's edition, you get this. And, yeah, you have access to these guys to begin with. Three different roles. You have an engineer, gunners, and pilots. Depending on which version you get more, I guess, objects starting out with. But mostly you're just going to be unlocking things as you play. I don't really have very much at all. It's pretty much just the stuff that I got, I guess, in the collector's edition. I don't know. Gender reversal. Yay. So you have some character customization and stuff, which that's cool. Yeah. Looks good to me. So let's go ahead and see if we can get into the game. Now, thankfully, you do have a practice mode.
Practice mode.
Though it's certainly not required, or neither is the tutorial. Pretty handy, though. I'm just going to do a quick join here and see if we can find something that's... okay, good. Well, there's a decent amount of people in here already, so hopefully it won't take long. As you can see, you're going to have two different teams here. One's red, one's blue. Go figure. I want to be on this guy's Pyramidion ship, whatever that is. Maybe, I guess. I don't know. Anyway, you build crews, somebody will pilot the ship, and the rest of your crew will do crew things. And I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead and get on the ship, because this can take a little while to get populated with people. Okay, looks like it is about to start up. Alright, so you have... well, this is a different place, I haven't been here. You have different maps that, of course, you get to go to and do these missions, and this one is a resource race, where teams fight for control of objectives. Whatever, man. Yeah, get stuff and get resources. That's nice. I don't know if I've done this one or not. But, as you can see here, I'm on a ship thing. Big airship. And I am an engineer, so I have two different kinds of repair tools at the moment. A fire extinguisher and... oh, I just fell. And a telescope. How's it already damaged? What the frick did they do to this thing? Anyway, the telescope can be used to, of course, look out and spot enemy ships. I am on... I'm having bad luck with gravity here. I should probably watch where I'm walking. Did I end up on red? I ended up on red. So apparently I'm looking out for blue ships. That could very well be one. So what we'd want to do is then shoot the crap out of those ships. And... yeah. Those are definitely ships. We should shoot them. That would be nice. Yeah. Unfortunately, these turrets, you can't turn them a significant amount. So you really do have to rely on your captain to pilot the ship properly. Which, at the moment, I don't really know what he's doing. But that's okay. There are different parts of the ship to take care of, too. Like this here, we have the hull armor. Ah, yes, this good old Captain Testes. I salute your balls, sir. That must be fantastic if you're named after him. We have the balloon, which, you know, you can repair that. These different parts of the ship will get shot. The engines, the weapons, they can all get hurt. I should probably take control of a gun here. And yes, you can fall off the edge. Okay, we're getting bombarded with fire. That's great. I really need a weapon. Let's do this. Ah! Much like Air Buccaneers... Oh, crap. I should probably turn that out. Yes, much like Air Buccaneers, it's really... Your time is going to be pretty dependent on your crew. So... Come on, cool down. So if you got a crappy crew, you're going to have a bad time. Like, seriously, there's just nothing you can do about it. Because this is not something that you can solo. Which, that was kind of my problem with Air Buccaneers, and it's kind of the problem here. It's just, it's a good experience if you have a good crew, or people to play with that know what they're doing. At the moment, it doesn't seem like any of us do. Just fine. Whatever. It'd be nice if I could just have a gun that was kind of pointed near... Okay, this is kind of... That hit them. I can't turn it to the left. Obviously, you want to be in communication with the rest of your crew. I don't really have a way of doing that, and other than the chat, I'm not voice chatted with these people. I don't think I can hit him. No, that's... I barely tapped him. Okay, come on. Reload! Aw, man, now that he's right in my sights, I got no bullets. On the other hand, if he comes around to this side, he's gonna die. Did he go underneath me? Where'd he go? Huh. I really don't know where he went. Aw, man. Where? What? The hull's on fire. Okay. That's, I have extinguishers, guys. That is a good thing. For some reason, the frame rate does seem to be very, very inconsistent with this. I don't know why. But I've very much noticed that. I don't know if it's because I'm running it in a window or what. Okay, it's on cooldown. That's actually one of the very few complaints I have with this, is the very inconsistent, unstable frame rate. Because otherwise, I actually quite like this. Well, and the fact that you need good people to play with, but that's not the fault of the game. That's inherent in its design. So, yeah, just beat it until it works. It's the solution to all problems in life, really. No, it is not. LGR does not endorse beating things senselessly. Unless it deserves it. With empirical evidence, of course. Okay, I am talking myself into a hole. Can't do that. Come on. There we go. That's good. Okay, so we're getting shot a lot here. The gun is on fire. And it appears we just rammed into a mountain or something. This is going significantly worse than my last playthrough. It appears the red team is at least getting points. You can see up there at the top. So that's nice. I'm not entirely sure. Ooh, crap. Not entirely sure how we're getting points. Because I'm not really super familiar with this mode. I'm not even sure if this is the right thing to use on this. I guess it is. Now, that's probably why we were falling down. The balloon was all dead. Some sort of resource capture in this mode, but the last one just seemed to be pretty much deathmatch. So I'm sure that's something that you can choose and do different kind of mode selections in the actual matchmaking lobby. I just did a quick one, so I don't know what the frick I'm doing. Okay, good enough. Okay, we got a balloon. Is nobody gonna pilot this thing? I'll pilot. Man, where'd Captain Ballsack or whatever his name is go? Okay. I don't know what I'm doing. Here, somebody else take it, please, because that's too much pressure. Yeah, that's the sign of a good team right there. Don't! I don't want to do it! Somebody else do it. But I do like the whole idea of this dirigible warfare thing. It's, you know, it's a lot slower paced than many other multiplayer shooter kind of turret defense things. I guess that's what you can call them. I don't know who I'm supposed to shoot at. I'm going to shoot at this guy. But yeah, I like this. And I'm curious as to what the adventure mode will add. It looks like the Kickstarter was just successful a couple days ago as of this recording. So, yeah. I mean, if you want to get... I'm assuming there's like early access and other cool things that you can get by just helping them reach their stretch goals and whatnot. But so that's coming, regardless. That's cool. Ah, I want to shoot stuff. I don't know what's up here. Yeah, you really need a good pilot to, like, have a chance. I'm not a good pilot, but I will at least attempt to do things. As long as people will shoot, that's cool. We got a big gun down there on the side. Use it. It's right there. Yeah, that one. Balls, yeah. Oh, sorry, Balzac. You can have it. Or Feroxius. Whatever, man. Guy's name wasn't Balzac. Oh, whoa. I don't want to get my head shot off. I don't even know if that can happen. I've never actually personally gotten hurt on here. Obviously, you do if your, like, ship blows up, but, otherwise, I think you as an individual are pretty much okay, unless you're really, really unlucky. What was damaged? The balloon is damaged. Oh, crap. I'll just go beat the balloon senseless. Beat the balloon with a wrench. Yeah, that makes sense. Now, you can, of course, upgrade and get better repair tools, and there's actually some things that you can't repair, I think, unless you have the right kind of tool. Or, no, it's actually this buff or something. There's some buffing something that you can do, and you get a repair tool to, like, extend it even further. I think if it gets damaged too far, you can't... I'm not sure of all the ins and outs of that. But, needless to say, there is a progression of stuff to do, which is nice. That is, assuming you don't get infuriated with your teammates just, well, doing like what I'm doing and just farting around. Come on. I do have different ammo types, too. Let me change to this other ammo type and see what I get. It's like pretty much the same thing. I'm sure there's a difference, but I don't know what it is. They're killing me with fire, guys. Wait, freaking D destroyed? No, I'm not destroyed. Maybe I destroyed something and it didn't have a name. Dang. Everything getting all burned up and stuff. It's sad. Okay. I don't know where that guy went. The fog, there's a lot of fog. It makes it really interesting because you do have to really keep track of things, keep spotting constantly where the other ships are and stuff. I like that. It's pretty cool. Oh, this thing's got problems. I swear, that's the sound effect from, Postal 2 that was used when you hit certain things with, I think, an axe. Makes me think I should be decapitating people and, like, kicking dogs or something. Anyway. Postal 2. It's a terrible game. You should never play it unless you just want to because it's awesome. It really is awesome. I like that game. Nothing to do with this, though. It appears we have all engineers on our, galleon, so that's not exactly a great team. Oh. There's action happening over there. Let's go down there. You can function with all engineers, but it's, you know, it's not exactly ideal. Where are we? Like, what are we even doing? Ah, dang it. I can't get too mad because I don't know what I'm doing even. Whoa, hey, now, that's not cool. Put that out. Oh, that was nice. Dang it. Ah! I think everything is pretty much burning. Yeah. It's kind of a problem. Oh, just get in range. Come on! So close, I can't aim up there. Oh, what a pain. Dang it. Oh, just out of reach. I guess I can put out fires. That kind of makes me feel better. You're gonna jump into it and just burn up? Nice job there. Yeah, that's not gonna help at all. Well, this is going, quite frankly, terribly. This is by far the worst run I've had on this game so far. I've only been playing it a couple hours, but still. That's what happens sometimes. Okay. That's the end of that. Alright. Well, we got a brand new ship that's not blown up. That's always good. Yeah, really, that's pretty much it. There's other game modes and stuff, but this is really the basic gameplay that you're going to be seeing. And, yeah, it's actually something I'd recommend checking out if you have people to play with. If not, it's probably going to go like this, and that's not very fun. You're not, like, getting points, you know, to upgrade yourself or whatever. I think there's also, like, microtransactions or something you can do in the store. I'm not sure. I haven't actually tried that, but... Yeah, I just, you know, I don't really care if this kind of thing is going on. If you have a good team, though, it's pretty friggin' fun, though. And I quite enjoyed it when things were going well. But that's, you know, that's typical. I just got lucky, and the team I was on was much better than I was, and they did well despite my being there. This, on the other hand, well, we're just kind of lost and floating over ice, and that's kind of funny. Oh, whatever. Yeah, check it out on Steam. It's on sale right now up until like the 21st of May. It'll go on sale again, I'm sure. And yeah, Kickstarter too. It's 'tis intriguing. So, I'm gonna kill myself. Thanks for watching.